My name is Ana Ruiz-Saenz. I am a postdoctoral scientist at UCSF, and I work in a lab in which we study the molecular mechanisms that drive tumor formation and cancer progression. And in particular, we are interested in a type of cancer, a type of breast cancer, that is named HER2-amplified breast cancer. And in the case of HER2-amplified cancers, the main driver of the disease is non-HER2. There is massive expression of the protein HER2 in the surface of the cancer cells. This cancer not only affects a significant number of women, but is a cancer that is associated with poor outcomes. Understanding the biology that is driving tumor formation is essential to design better treatment for these patients. So it's known that HER2 has been the driver of the disease, and for that reason, over the years, a lot of efforts have been placed in developing inhibitors for HER2. And one of these inhibitors is a well-known targeted therapy that is called Herceptin. So this antibody is meant to block the activity of HER2 and has been definitely a game changer for the patients who have HER2-amplified cancers. For a lot of drugs in the clinic, cancer cells develop resistance, but the way that HER2 works is not by itself. One of the key players of mechanisms of resistance is HER3. The way that these proteins work is by interacting with each other, forming what we call a dimer. So when they form a dimer, they activate each other and they can signal pathways inside the cell that lead to growth and survival of the cancer cells. But unfortunately, HER3 right now remains undruggable. And a lot of efforts are placed to develop an inhibitor for HER3 in many laboratories, in companies, and some of these inhibitors are right now in clinical trials. So in our lab, we wanted to interrogate how cancer cells will respond to those HER3 inhibitors once they are there. If HER2 has been the game changer, will HER3 really be the end for HER2-amplified cancers? So the idea was to inject these cancer cells lacking HER3 expression into mice and wait and see if the mice develop tumors. The expected outcome was that those cells were unable to form tumors, and that is what is known. But what we did in this experiment is to push out the limit and monitor the tumor growth of these mice for longer than was done before. But if you wait enough, you get to see the result. The cancer cells were finding a way to overcome the requirement of HER3.